Today I'm going to be showing you guys my skincare routine, my acne, hyperpigmentation, acne scarring, like all that stuff, and it's gotten it all nice and clear. Yeah, so first I'm going to explain the products that I use to you guys, and then I'm going to be showing you guys. But anyway, I'm gonna explain the products to you guys, and then I'm going to show you guys how I use them. So let's just get right into it. I'm gonna be inserting pictures as well of my acne before and after, like using these products and everything. Okay, so I had to fix the camera. Now it should be much brighter. In high school, I'm a rising junior in high school now, and I've been struggling with acne since I was in sixth grade. It's been like, it's been tough, but I think now that I have a grasp on things, it's a lot easier to manage. And I really wasn't doing everything that I could to try and get it better. Like, I'm gonna be straight up, I was like pretty much just encouraging more acne to come on my face. No one wants acne on their face, obviously, but the things that I was doing to it wasn't helping at all. And with the acne, I was popping my pimples, I was messing with my skin. So then comes along the hyperpigmentation. Last February, I started taking control of my skin. I started using better products that was like good for my skin, and I cleared up my skin very well. I started eating better. I started drinking a lot more water, like a gallon, maybe a gallon and a half a day. I only think about your ass when it rains in LA. Then, like, literally, I think my high school, like the school that I go to, really like just made my acne pop up again. Like, I don't want to make it look like, oh, it was just your fault. Like, has nothing to do with your school. Like, I literally think my dusty ass school brought my acne back. I tracked to the beginning of sophomore year, last year. My acne just came back. It would like go away, they would leave scars. So it was already just bad. It's really bad. Finals week, which was like, I would say like a month ago, I really started getting back on my shit. So yeah, I'm gonna show you guys those products, and I'm gonna give you guys a couple of tips as well. So first of all, I wanna start out by saying that just because these products worked for my skin and getting rid of my hyperpigmentation and acne doesn't mean it's gonna work for you. Everyone is different. I definitely realized that when I started my skincare journey. Second, consistency is definitely key. Like, you need to be consistent and rigorous with your skincare routine, or it's just not gonna work. So first, I highly recommend, if you're struggling with acne, you should invest in some kind of spin brush or like a cleansing brush. I use the Mia 2 by Clarisonic. Clarisonic sells different brush heads for different needs. I have the one that tackles acne, and they do have other brush heads. Before I was using the sensitive brush head. So I use this twice a day, once at night and once in the morning. Along with the Clarisonic brush, I use this tea tree skin clearing facial wash from the Body Shop, and it looks like this. It's in like a green bottle. This stuff will last you a while, like, because you're only gonna need like a dime amount per time you use it. I had this one bottle that lasted me like literally a year. So what you buy from the Body Shop typically lasts. I know how nationwide the Body Shop is, or international it is, but it's a really good company. They have all natural vegan products, so there's no like extra chemicals in there that are harmful to your skin or just like not doing the right things for you. I'm not vegan or anything, so I'm not being like, oh, like, go switch to vegan products, but like, really, their stuff works and it's all natural, so it's not gonna be harsh on your skin or anything. If anything, it probably just won't work, like, depending on your skin and what your needs are. It probably just won't work, or like, it will work and not harm your skin. Like, it won't harm your skin at all. It's either gonna not work or it's gonna work. Like, that's it. It's not gonna do anything in between. It's not gonna mess up your skin or anything. Big thing is, tea tree oil is so important for your skin. Tea tree oil is just good for acne, hyperpigmentation. It just has so many benefits. It's even good for your hair growth. I try to incorporate it in any way I can into my skincare routine. So after I wash my face, I use Thayer's Witch Hazel. They have different scents and stuff. You don't have to always get a scent, but I have this one in cucumber. Toner is very important for your skin, especially if you're trying to get rid of hyperpigmentation or scars, because toner just progressively fades away those scars. Witch Hazel is very good at purifying the skin, so get rid of acne and all that stuff. Thayer's Witch Hazel is kind of pricey. It's like $10.95. I got that bottle in Maryland, so I'm not really that sure. It might be cheaper or more expensive where you are. If you don't feel like paying that much money for Witch Hazel, I totally get it. You can just slide by like Target or something. It has Witch Hazel for like $2 and it lasts you a really long time. And if you just buy some of this Witch Hazel, you can either put it in a spray bottle, spray it on your face, or you can pair it with some cotton pads. After I tone it, I do use a serum. I think serums are necessary because they give you more benefits than your moisturizer could. I highly recommend buying a serum. There are cheap serums that still work amazingly. There are a lot more expensive serums that still work amazingly. So this is the serum I'm using now, again from the Body Shop, and it is called the Body Shop Tea Tree Anti-Imperfection Daily Solution. Stuff is so good. It's not just for blemished skin, because tea tree oil is good for everything. I put this stuff on at night in the morning and it just makes my skin smoother, and it's been noticeably clearing my blemishes. So highly recommend this stuff. After I use my serum and my toner, I go straight into moisturizing. First thing I use to moisturize my skin is Ambi Fade Cream. It was a godsend when I found this, because my hyperpigmentation was so bad, guys. Like, you don't understand, it was so bad I couldn't even walk out the house without makeup. Like, it was that bad. I also use rosehip oil. Are so good for your skin. Even if you do have oily skin, you just need to pick the right oil that is good for you. Okay, so the last thing I use is this organic Bulgarian rose water. Stuff is a little pricey, but it is good for your skin. It's like $14, but like, it's worth it because it lasts a long time. Rose water is so good for acne scarring, hyperpigmentation. It just has so many benefits. Spray this stuff on my face and it just changes your skin, man. Like, it's just so good. I recommend spray bottles. Skincare routine, like, spray bottles just really change up your shit, man. Like, they just add like a glowing effect to your skin. I can't explain it. You need to be exfoliating your skin at least 2 to 3 times a week. 2 to 3 times a week you need to be exfoliating your skin. And that is really what's gonna change your skin, because you can be having the best skincare products, but if those dead skin cells are just piling up on your face, what, like, you're not gonna see any difference with the new skin cells that are being produced. Oh, we're going back to my favorite store. The Body Shop has this product called the Drops of Youth Liquid Peel. Changed my life. This little bottle lasts me like a year, because I exfoliate 2 times a week, and you literally just need a pump of this stuff and then you're done. What this stuff does is that you just pump it into your hand while your face is still damp after you wash it. You're just gonna rub it all over your face and you're gonna notice that it clumps up, and that is your dead skin coming off your face. And I'm telling you guys, it's so weird, but like satisfying at the same time. I have been recently, in like the last month, using a derma roller on my skin twice a week. Now, I do exfoliate my skin twice a week, so the days that I exfoliate, I use the derma roller, so it just works out. Basically, like a bunch of little needles. I don't know if you guys see it. It's a bunch of little needles that aren't painful at all when you roll it on your skin. Noticeable, it's not painful, it's not anything. It just makes little pokes in my skin, and it's gonna produce collagen. And with that collagen, new skin cells will be created, and that means less hyperpigmentation. Yeah, so those are basically all the products I use. So I'm gonna show you guys right now how I wash my skin and all of that, and yeah, bye. Okay guys, I know that was a weird transition from nighttime to morning, but yeah, it's morning time now. I'm getting ready for work.
It is 7:27. I have like 15 more minutes left, so we're gonna do this really quick. I'm gonna use my Clarisonic brush and tea tree face.
Okay, so first what I start out by doing is just dampening my face with a little bit of warm water, and then I rinse off my Clarisonic brush and add about a quarter size amount of my face wash, and then I just start washing my face with the Clarisonic brush. It is on a timer, so I really don't have to worry about how long I'm washing my face for. Ain't got no love for the feds. Can they fan go to your head? Fuck with me, watch where you tread. After that, I just rinse off my brush and I wipe it off with my like face rag that I use, and then I wet the rag again and wipe off the soap on my face, and I do that about 2 times. Then I use my Thayer's Witch Hazel and I just spray that all over my face, and then I eventually rub it into my skin. Then with the Body Shop's Anti-Imperfection Serum, I just take like one pump of that, put it in my hands, rub it around in my hands, and then I rub it on my face. Then I take the rosehip oil and AmbiFade cream. I take about a pea-sized amount of the AmbiFade cream, and I take about 5 drops of the rosehip oil, and I just put that in my hands. I rub them together, and then I rub it on my face. Then I just take my Rosa Demacina spray, and I spray that all over my face and then rub it in. And then I also take a little bit of black castor oil and just put that on my eyebrows and my eyelashes.
Okay guys, so that is the end of my tutorial. I hope you learned something new from my skincare routine. I know a few of my friends were asking me to do skincare routine because they were pretty interested in my results from doing this. Like, comment and subscribe, and come back next week for a new video. I'm trying to be consistent this summer and hopefully into the school year.